and wearing past Cindy, distinguished speakers who have come from abroad to be with us this morning, and delegates as well. Ladies and gentlemen, the honor is all mine to be here this morning to share this special few minutes, whatever it's going to be, with you. The first time that I was invited to this was last year, and I had no hesitation in accepting it again this year, because this is a great place to be. A very good morning to you all. For the spirit that God has given us does not make us timid. Instead, His Spirit fills us with power, with love, and with self-control. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. It's truly an honor for me to be invited to speak to you this morning as you embark on day 2 of the 3rd Conference for Women of the Frontline in Fiji. I wish to firstly congratulate the organizers for bringing this event home with the intent to enrich the spiritual and social empowerment of Fijian women. Women on the Front Lines is committed to empower, to equip, and mobilize Christian women through conferences, training events, outreaches, and missions, which projects women from a variety of streams to receive encouragement, equipping, and impartation. And my heartiest congratulations to the movement for getting it right. Women's empowerment cannot be achieved in isolation. It requires sisterhood and sponsorship and mentoring. And you are doing just that and doing it very well. The status of women today is changing, but at a very slow pace. In fact, it is safe to say that more than before, women's roles have expanded. Women are now able to access education, better health care, hold more decision-making power, and have better economic participation opportunities. But the question we need to ask is, has this ended the discrimination and second-class treatment of women in our communities altogether? Each day, we still find news articles about women getting beaten in their homes, being killed at the hands of their intimate partners, being sexually exploited, and being limited in their opportunities based on gender stereotypes and inequality. All these because of the false notion that women are inferior. Gender inequality is one of the most prevalent forms of social inequality, and it exists all over the world, with different effects in different regions. These differences are primarily due to cultural legacies, historical development, geographical location, and last but not least, the religious norms which predominate in society. Religion plays a pivotal role in the cultural life of different spaces. It is deeply rooted in people's experiences and influences the socioeconomic and political direction of societies. Religious belief is obviously complex, and it varies across time and space. Today, more than ever before, the world recognizes that gender equality is critical for true and inclusive national development. In order for nations to achieve gender equality, we women need to step up. We need to step forward and put our hand up in whatever front line of influence we may currently be serving in. May it be religion, media, government, education, business, family, arts, entertainment, politics. We need to shed our cloaks of timidity, because that is not from God. The spirit that God has given us is one of power. Let that power spill forth in whatever front line you might be serving in. Conferences such as this give us a great opportunity to reflect on the roles that we women play in society. And I would like to particularly focus on one key role, that of a mother. A role that is unique to us women, and women alone. A role that has the unmatched potential to shape a community and a nation. How much effort are we putting into this role at home? And particularly for us women who work in other front lines outside of the family, how much time are we investing into our families and the raising of our children, the raising of the future of our nation?
There is no doubt among UN member states, including Fiji, that for Agenda 2030 or the UN Sustainable Development Goals to be achieved, women must be at the front line. The Fijian government does not see women as any bit inferior to men. The 2013 Constitution guarantees equal rights to all Fijians, including women, with political will of the government reflected in its international obligations, like the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, and the consistently increasing budget towards the national women's machinery to implement the objectives of the convention. For the first time, gender has been formally incorporated into a 5-year and 20-year national development plan, which seeks to empower women to reach their full development potential. The national gender policy complements this aim of promoting gender equality in all aspects of development in Fiji by eradicating institutional and social barriers to inequality. Our ministry has also strengthened its ties with stakeholders, including faith-based organizations, in recognition of the fact that gender is a cross-cutting issue and requires partnerships to counter inequality and discrimination. We also promote women's economic participation by supporting women-led income-generating projects and aim to eliminate violence against women and children through our programs. With government doing its part in the form of policy making and government-funded programs for women's development, I wish to reiterate at this juncture the important role that faith-based organizations play in women's empowerment. Faith actors are critical in dismantling structures and practices that promote inequality. And as women of faith, we must work for women's empowerment. We need to understand that women's full and equal participation in decision-making and in the economy is critical for ending poverty, achieving economic growth, and ensuring peaceful communities. With the theme for this year's conference, based on Isaiah 45:1-3, I am sure that a lot will be learned over these 3 days by attendees, especially in realizing the great worth of each and every individual as a creation of God. Human rights and constitutional rights of people has come much later. Our scriptures demanded equal and dignified treatment of each other much earlier. And the simplest, most well-known verse being, love thy neighbor like you love yourself. To conclude, the scripture theme conference is also a reminder to us women to be bold in living our lives according to values and principles we hold dear, and with the belief that we are capable of achieving the seemingly insurmountable. We must move forward in the direction of our dreams and aspirations, for there is a lot that we can impact on within our families and communities. The opportunity we have as women to have a lasting positive impact on the front line of our individual families has the unmatched potential to ripple beyond into our communities and to continue to mold our nation into one we can all be proud of. With these words, I wish you all a very fulfilling and spiritually filled next day or so in the Women in the Frontline Conference in Lautoka. And for those of you who are visiting, I hope you get to enjoy the hospitality of the Fijian people.